Hey everybody, this is a video kind of off the cuff about some tough neighbors that I have. This is a neighborhood where we belong. We've been here for a little over a year now, and I've been kind of checking out the neighbors, and they've been checking us out, if you understand what I mean. My wife and I and my family is conservative. And I found out how conservative these neighbors are last night by... I got invited over to a fire pit last night. The adults in the neighborhood are a little apprehensive to talk very much about their political outlook and their outlook on life. But late last night, there was two young people there, a male and a female. They're both in their mid-20s. And both of them have been through extended university education. So the topic that I brought up was woke in the universities. And I really got surprised that what these young people told me about their topics in their universities that they were forced to look into and study for a semester or something like that. And the young lady told me that the universities pick out the students that are more vulnerable. And she said only the vulnerable students bit on to the whole woke stuff. The stable students completed what they needed to and didn't buy into it. And I said, well, what's the percentage? He goes, the majority of us in the universities are not woke. We don't believe in that. And then the young man spoke up and he says, these people who buy into this woke stuff, they're mentally ill. They are disturbed people. And they're being taken advantage of. And I went, wow, okay, finally. Okay, because I had seen them around the neighborhood. And I spoke to both of them a couple of times because we have these weekly neighborhood get-togethers outside. And finally, when their parents were away, they really talked openly with me. And it was wonderful to hear that they're not into that stuff. They're conservatives. What I mean by tough neighborhood is the adults here are kind of guarded about what they'll say and what they'll speak about and how and their behavior. But these young people that I sat with last night, the young man said, do you see that new house going in down the street? Said, yeah. And he goes, do you know what happened to the last house that was there? No. Because when we moved in, it was an empty lot with a big hole in the middle of it. And he said, that was a meth lab. I said, oh, crap, really? And he goes, yeah. You know what ended it? Was the men in this neighborhood ended that. I said, well, okay, tell me more. Is the people living in that house and the customers that were buying the meth from that house were robbing their cars. Then one day, the men in the neighborhood went over to that house and said, give us back our property now. Or we're calling the cops and we're going to get you out of here. And of course they didn't have the property, didn't give it back, but that's where he ended the conversation. It was the dads in the neighborhood ended that. And when the authorities came in and arrested all of them, because they were cooking in there, they had to come in there with excavators and dump trucks and dig the entire building out and get rid of it. But he told me straight out that was their dads in the neighborhood and the other men in the neighborhood who forced them out. I went, man, this is the place that we belong. This is where we belong, right here. What I'm trying to do is a little bit of intel on who my neighbors are and where their thoughts are at. And I found out last night for sure that this is exactly where my conservative family belongs, is right here. We've been here for a little over a year. And I've been slowly talking to them about preparedness, neighborhood watch, things like that. these guys have already got it together, but I think they're feeling us out to see who we are also. So it was good to hear that those two young people are not woke. And the woke stuff is the reason why my daughter didn't go to a university. And I'll give you a quick scenario. They start in the high schools here, as you probably know. One day she came home from school, and every day after school I would sit down with her, you know, what did you learn? What was the most important thing you learned today? Every day I'd sat down with her for about 15 minutes. And one day she said, well, we got the day off. Okay, why? And she said they had an anti-gun rally at the high school. I said, really? She told me, so I asked her, what did you do? She said, me and two of my friends went and had coffee. I refused to participate in any of that. Apparently that's how these two young people are who live right here on my street are also. This was good to hear. There's hope out there. There's more of us people who are conservative and believe in the Constitution than what the mass media is telling us. There's hope out there. The young people are not brainwashed. And as far as that trans stuff, okay, they brought up the topic about, and the young lady told me about how she knows a young man who's going through the transitioning stuff, and he's got a kid. And he completely ignores the kid because he's a pure narcissist. His entire life is about himself. And these kids can see it. So I was curious about where the young people are standing on that. And so far, that's my daughter and these two young people who live next to us are conservatives, and they're not buying the bullshit. In fact, they won't even subscribe to TikTok or any of the other Marxist bullshit online. Neither one of them were surfing their phones last night when we were talking. It was awesome to see. So I thought I'd share that with you guys. Have a great day.